Hi guys, and welcome to our 32nd official episode on the Jesus Girl Entertainment Podcast. This is our 32nd episode for the entire podcast, but it's only our second episode for the season that we're in, which is Boss Up. If you guys haven't already caught our first episode featuring Elisha's story, please do go back and stream that episode. It's an awesome episode. She dropped some very great nuggets. Her song is playing in the beginning of that. She also released a book. She's doing some apparel. So you guys go and support her and support the movement, the Dashing Nation. And so tonight for this Freedom Friday, we're going to be talking from the topic of powerful partnerships, hashtag do it yourself, DIY. Powerful partnerships. Yeah, hashtag DIY. And so it kind of sounds like a contradiction, but it's really not. I'm gonna make it make sense. Over the course of me continuing with this work and bringing things to pass, God is starting to send people from all different directions to that have different things they want to impart, different things they want to contribute, different things they feel that will help the business to be more beneficial. And so you guys know that we're very prayerful. We're keeping things within the guidelines of what God would have us to do. That's why we just went through that pure heart season and we're constantly doing our heart checks. Yet God will send partners with the work that you're doing, especially if you're claiming that it's not a just a you thing, it's a God thing, then other people should be allowed to be in on it. The only thing with that, with having other people to be in on it, other people to contribute with it, is that you have to know that in the event that something happens with another person, that you have to be able to pick up that ball, because who's going to be held responsible if something doesn't happen or if something doesn't work? I actually saw a headline with a young lady that was an artist that was supposed to go forth and do a performance, but she couldn't because somebody that was on her team forgot a very instrumental piece of equipment that they needed to have the performance done. So the entire performance was canceled. And so we know that because we represent the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, that no balls will be dropped. We're not dropping it. We're going to continue in excellence. So in order for us to do that, that's why we have the hashtag DIY, is being knowledgeable about every single part of your business, every single part of what it is that God has called you to do. Not to say that you're luring over people, that you're luring in different directions, that you're not in your own lane. But if this is something that God has given you to oversee, you have to know that you got to be, even if you're not an accountant, know a little bit about accounting. If you're not a part of the music department, know a little bit about music. If you're not a part of the actual speaking part, just know a little bit about it, so that you'll be able to save it and you won't have to cancel out on the opportunity just because somebody else dropped the ball. And so I'm going to take a text and we're going to talk from Luke chapter 5. I'm going to start at verse 1 and then read down. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. So washing their nets meant that they were done for the day and they had done whatever they were going to do for that entire time of fishing, right? Verse 3, and he entered into one of the ships, and the he that we're referring to is Jesus, entered into one of the ships, which was Simon. Simon, we know that he renamed Peter, but at this time he was being referred to as Simon, was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land, and he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep. Go fully into this. Don't hold back. Do it. If you're going to do it all the way, right? And let down your nets for a drop. And Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. So I've been doing this for a long time and I don't have any gain. I haven't seen any progress. Nevertheless, at thy word, I'm going to be obedient, is what he said. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Verse 6, and when they had this done, they enclosed the great multitude of fishes and their net break. See, obedience is better than sacrifice. And what God is calling you to do, he's going to give you the entire blueprint for it. Even if it hadn't worked in times past, if it wasn't successful in times past, if he's saying that now is the time to do it, then do it. Do it. Get over the fear of failure. Get over the fear of rejection. Get over the fear of it not working. If he's saying it's going to work, do it. Catch it while the water is troubled. Jump right in there and get what it is that he has for you. Verse 7, and they beckoned unto their partners. Oh, wait. Go back. 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 Okay, and Simon answered and said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Verse 6, and when they had this done, when they obeyed, when they did what it was that God told them to do, everything that he told you to do, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes in their net break. I'm going to stop right there, but I'm going to continue reading. There's been times in my life where I hadn't seen full progress, and I thought, why am I doing this? This is not even working. And then it dawned on me, you're not even fully doing what it is that you've been, that he's told you to do. You only doing it halfway. Obey all of it, every single thing that he told you to do, and then you'll see the fruit. So it, maybe that's for somebody. Maybe you're like, oh, this is not working, but maybe you got to do this and that. Maybe he gave you a few more rules to follow or a few more things to do, but you're just doing as much as you want to do, the bare minimum, and so you're not seeing the fullness of it. Verse 7, and they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships so that they began to sink. And so they had so much that they had to ask other people to come and help them. Other people to come and help them with what it is that Jesus had blessed them to be able to gain at that time. What God's getting ready to bless you with is going to be he's giving you much, because it's not just for you, it's for others. And I really want to talk to this, and that's why I played the song that I played before. I'm going to play another song later that's going to encourage us, because the system there are some things in the system that are rigged. We're very aware of this. There are some things that are unjust. There are some people in high places that have the resources, but they're doing and distributing how they want to distribute them. And that's why God has to position his people so that things are done properly, that things are done justly. And I'm going to read another verse. I'm in that verse right there. I'm going to read another passage of scripture. This is Proverbs 22, verse 7. The rich ruleth over the poor, and the borrower is servant to the lender. Let me read that again. The rich ruleth over the poor, and the borrower is servant to the lender. This is a part of the reason why, even in my own personal life, becoming an entrepreneur and seeking after God fully for a way to become an owner of things versus having other people to give things to myself and to my children. Because when you're at the mercy of other people, they're going to give you what they feel that you're worth. They're going to distribute to you as they want to distribute to you. And that all the time is not fair. And most of the time it's only in their favor. And so even with doing it yourself, you have to know that God's not just allowing you to do it yourself for yourself. He's allowing you to do it yourself for other people. You may be the one that's breaking into the vault that's going to be a blessing to all the people that have been struggling, that have been in poverty, that have been downtrodden, that have been overlooked. One thing that's terrible with human nature is that people prey on weak people. I've worked in organizations where it doesn't even matter whether or not sometimes they pull a race card, not all the time. You can be an elderly person, and they feel like you shouldn't be working. You should retire by now. And you'll see people that are even of that same race preying on the weak. People prey on the weak. But as people of God, we don't do that. We uplift those who are down. We help those who are in need of help. And so that's why God is strategically moving and shifting things so that things can be done right. But the lack of people that are willing to put in the work and actually see it to come to pass is the reason that we're seeing lack. And so we're talking about powerful partnerships. I'm going to kind of like highlight, and I won't be on here long tonight. I'm going to kind of highlight some notes that I took from a sermon that I heard from Bishop T.D. Jakes. And so, okay, so he said that, and these are just the notes that I took. I'm going to link the actual video in the description so you can go back and watch it at your own time, at your own leisure. But he said that we should we have three different friends. We should put them in categories like this. And he referred to them as the three C's. So the first one is your confidants, those you can talk to, be transparent with, and be honest. These represent your inner circle. So these are people that you can let your hair down with, that you don't have to be concerned about them judging you or looking at you any kind of way or throwing your title up in your face. Or even if you fall or you do something that you're not expected to do in that role, they'll correct you in love, but they're not the ones who are one to jump on trying to expose you or jump on trying to criticize you or downplay you because of a mistake or a moment. And so for me, this would be people considered like close family, especially my children, God, of course, Some people, that's very, very, very small. That circle is very, very small. And that's what he said. It would be small. He said, if you have three confidants and a lifetime, then you've done extremely well. So we're talking in regards to partnerships, powerful partnerships. So with building partnerships, got to know how to put people in categories. Not to say that just because you're a partner with the business, or just because I've accepted you as an employee, or you're with the movement, that you're a confidant. You may not be in that category. You as the leader, you're the one who has to pray and ask God for discernment to know who's to be in which category. And that's not to say I don't love you any less. It's just I have to put people in their proper categories. This is where organization comes in. Because if I put somebody too close to me that doesn't belong close to me, that could really be bad for the entire establishment. Second group of people, he said, are constituents. Now, the constituents, they're with the cause, but they're not for you. So they're for what you're for, but they're not particularly for you. So let me go back. The confidants are for you. They're for you if you're winning. They're for you if you're losing. These are people that are for you, okay? They're just for you. They love you regardless. If you come out and you wreck the house when you get ready to sing or whatever it is that you're doing, they're applauding for you. Or if you come out and it's terrible, they're still applauding for you because they're for you. Now, constituents, they're not for you. They're for your cause. So they may be like, oh, I like the fact that you give back to the homeless. Or I like the fact that this is about women empowerment. Or I like the fact that this is about men empowerment. Or I like the fact that this is about healing. I like the fact that this is about deliverance. So they'll be with you as long as they're for the cause. They're not for you. So let's not get it twisted and think, oh, this person is supporting me. No, they're not supporting you. They're supporting the cause. They're supporting the God in you. They're supporting the movement. So this is how we're categorizing pieces, people. This is how we're categorizing those that God has sent to help us with the movement, help us with the organization. The third category of people that he says are, we did the confidants, the constituents, and now the third one is the comrades. So the comrades are not for you. Neither are they for what you're for. They're just against what you're against. So if you're against unrighteousness, they're with you. If you're against racial injustice, they're against that, they're with you. If you're against inequality, they're with you. They're against that. So just knowing how we're to categorize the powerful partnerships that we're establishing. And knowing that even with you establishing partnerships, that it's still your responsibility. You're at the head of it. So really making sure, and I believe self-care is still essential. I did a podcast on that. If you haven't heard it, go back and listen to it. It's not about spending a lot of money on yourself, but really spending a lot of time with God so you can establish yourself in wholeness and healthiness so that you're not hurting people, that you're not giving out toxic information, you're not hindering anyone, but you're uplifting people because you've already taken that time to have yourself built up, to have yourself uplifted. This is very essential for leaders. And so for tonight, if I want you to take anything away from, if God wants you to take anything away from this podcast, know that yes, there are some great things on the horizon because the system is not, there are some things in the system that are not right. There are some things that are being held up that are deserving to people that are in need. And if we don't have the right people in position, those things won't be released. This is a time that we need to be bombarding heaven for him to release the blessings upon his people so that we can put things in their proper position because he gave us dominion. And so with having your powerful partnerships, know how to put them in categories, know how to do everything, even if you're not in every department, just a little bit, just need to know a little bit about it. So if it's just connect this wire, put this there, or have this person stand here, just knowing a little bit about it so we're not dropping the ball. And before I get off of here, I really just want to make mention about what just took place with Sha'Carri. I know this is hot news. I've seen more people talk about the downfall of what took place to her that versus people that were at, people that didn't even congratulate her when she won are talking about what took place with her. And so I really want to just give her a word of encouragement. Sha'Carri from the Jesus Girl Entertainment Podcast, from the Jesus Girl brand and movement, we are praying for you. We thank you for your contribution to history and what you have done. We send our condolences to you and your family for the loss of your mother. And I just pray that things do work in your favor and that we're able to turn this around. God to turn this around so that he can get the glory out of it. And so that's all I have for you guys on this Freedom Friday. Build those powerful partnerships, put them in categories, And then as you're building the powerful partnerships and putting people in categories, still be aware of how to do things. Even if you call them in, they may be the specialist. General doctors do call in specialists. Just because they called in a specialist, they may be more, they may know how to do it at a higher level because they were trained in this. Yeah, I still know how to do a little bit of, I know how to do it a little bit. Just have even a little bit of knowledge will help you to be able to stop the pitfalls and the things that the enemy may try to send. Yeah. Dear most gracious Father, how we thank you and praise you for this opportunity to speak on this Freedom Friday. We thank you that you're enlarging our territory. We thank you that you're expanding our borders. We thank you that you're giving us the ability to have our own. We're buying our ownership back. You're giving us freedom. You're giving us financial freedom. You're giving us emotional healing that we need so that we can walk in the freedom that you have given us. Father, I pray for everybody that's on this podcast that you may bless them in their business endeavors, that you may send the right people around them, give them the discernment to know who to have in their inner circle, who needs to be on the outer court, and what positions that needs to be played. Father, I pray that you even give them keen knowledge and wisdom and understanding so that they can be able to do all things. Even if they don't specialize in it, they'll be able to do it so that the ball is not dropped. Father, we thank you that you are raising us up to be kingdom ambassadors and that you're going to get the glory out of our lives. It's in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus that we seal this prayer, and we thank you for being God and God all by yourself. Hallelujah and amen.
When the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory, oh, glory, oh, glory, glory, glory. Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walked through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop and we ran up.
When the glory comes, it'll be ours, it'll be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure.
Of a crowd, they march with the torch, we gon' run with it now. Never look back, we done gone hundreds of miles. From dark roads, heroes, to become a hero. Facing the League of Justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal, a king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a bald ego. The biggest weapon is to stay peaceful. We sing, our music is the cuts that we bleed through. Somewhere in a dream we had an epiphany. Now we right the wrongs in history. No one can win a war individually. It takes the wisdom of the elders, young people's energy. Welcome to the story we call victory. The coming of the Lord, my eyes have seen the glory.
One day when the glory comes, it'll one day.